Shredmaster Challenge of the Day number 96. We're going to be doing some string skipping and some wide stretching with some diminished seventh patterns today. Here goes. Okay, so it's really pretty straightforward. What's nice about the first and third strings and the second and fourth strings in pairs is that even though there's some string skipping involved, when you deal with diminished sevenths, they're going to be at the same frets. All right, so I'm starting up here at fret 20, 17, and 14, and it's the same frets when I jump over to the third string. So I'm just doing some pull-offs, really, on the first string, and then I like to pick the next string, so... And then I'm going to go down to 17 and do it again. So I'm kind of just shifting to what was my middle note with my pinky and making that the high note. So I'm doing it in two different positions on the first and third string. All right, and one thing to note there, by the way, before I move on to the next part of the pattern, is the way that I move over to it. Notice that I'm kind of stretched out. I go to sort of a relaxed hand, in fact, even a little bit of kind of a condensed hand where my fingers are bunched together for just a moment. So once I'm done here, I'm going to bring my pinky over to 17, and then during that note, I'm going to spread my hand back out to that shape so that I'm kind of there when I need to be playing it, not in motion still. I don't want my fingers to still be in transit at the moment when I'm already supposed to be playing that note. All right, so that's an important thing to remember about your actual transitions between your shapes, is that sometimes your hand is really far apart, sometimes it's relaxed, sometimes it's even crunched together really closely so you can kind of hand it off to the next note, because this is finger independence. You're handing off one note to the next from one finger to the next. So that finger needs to stay there and not pick up your whole hand like a block all the time. That's a big thing. A lot of people do that by accident because we're just kind of thinking about one shape at a time, but we're not thinking about the transition. So think about this as a lesson in transitions today. All right, but ultimately, here's what we're doing, all right? So pick, pull off, pick, 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 transition over, pull off, pick, pick, pick. Now I'm actually gonna slide into 19 on the second string and start this whole pattern again on the second and fourth string. So that was pick, pull off, pick, pick, pick. Same idea, going to 16. And then slide down a half step and you're done. All right, so all together, a little more slowly than the first time. All right, you give it a try and I'll see you again tomorrow.